Hi friends, I know I've made some pretty tall claims in my title, so bear with me. I'm a new YouTuber, I'm still learning the ropes, but maybe I could say something that could transform your life magically. Why should I, a fellow traveler, be able to do that? There's a Sanskrit saying which I'll directly say it in English, which says that in the night, a small lamp can do what the sun is not able to do. So friends, let me start. Bear with me, listen to the entire video, and whether you like it or dislike it, give me your honest comments at the end of it. I will really appreciate. Now, in a lot of my previous videos on this whole 5-minute mystic series, I have talked about how The Secret, written by Rhonda Byrne, and the law of attraction really changed my life, especially after I connected it to the teachings of Indian rishis for the last thousands of years and Indian yogis in the last several decades. But I am appalled at the massive secret industry that has been created. Okay, all these gurus going around telling you and these saying that, you know what, you just think good thoughts and your money will flow into your life and everything will happen just perfectly. Just keep thinking good thoughts, all of it will happen. I ask you genuinely, how many of you have really benefited, except giving you momentary pleasure thinking, the moment you are thinking this, everything is falling in place? Have really all of you guys become rich? Or have only those speakers, the people who give those talks, the only ones who have minted money out of you, out of advertisements, etc., etc.? But that does not mean that the law of attraction is not true. Hindu scriptures talk about it. So then, what is the problem? The problem is our ancient gurus, our Rishi Munis talked about a holistic approach to life. They talked about the law of attraction in a much higher spiritual manner. The West, in its typical materialistic nature, has reduced it to the universe into some sort of a check signing authority. That is the problem. The other problem is this. You see, the Western mind has always considered God as some sort of a very strict old man sitting high above. You know, that is their definition of God. Therefore, there was always this habit of requesting, begging him for more, more, more. Now, the New Age philosophers have replaced the word God from universe, but their concept of the universe remains the same. You ask the universe and it shall be granted. You beg him and he will give you all that you want. A car, an iPhone, everything he will give you. That is exactly what the Indian way of thought has never been. The ancient Rishi Munis did tell you to do rituals and worship because they knew that the common man will not understand that the power lies in his mind. So they made certain concepts. Okay, you worship this god in so and so fashion and your wish will be granted. But the Upanishads and all other Vedantic texts very clearly knew that you are the universe. All of us have heard this word, Aham Brahmasmi. It's very popular these days. But do you really, really feel it? And is that the reason why the law of attraction is not working for you? Is that the part which the West still does not get? Can I request you to do a simple exercise right now with me? Look, you don't have to really look at me. So just do a small, simple exercise. Humor me. Close your eyes. Preferably if you are in your balcony or you can be outdoors. If you cannot be, no problems. Especially in these scenarios, you can be indoors. Close your eyes, imagine at least. Imagine the trees. Imagine the sun. imagine this beautiful, beautiful planet in all its glory, whatever impresses you, mountains, seas, and feel yourself a part of it. Feel the sun, and then say in your heart, Aham Brahmasmi, I am all of this. Now imagine the billions of suns in the Milky Way and the billions of Milky Ways, and repeat 3 times to yourself, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi. I don't care if you say this in Sanskrit or English or anything. I don't want to add any further rituals to the amount of rituals that have been built. But feel that you are the universe. When you feel, the question arises, if you yourself are the universe, then you yourself have put the obstacles in your path. Then who are you begging for? There must be a reason why you did this. Vivekananda said this, and to save time, I'm saying it directly in English and not Sanskrit. The entire universe, okay, all the things that are happening are within you only. It is you who has put your hands in front of your eyes and are saying that it is dark. Something to that translation effect. Do you understand what that means? You created this journey of your life to learn certain things. Now, you would say, that's all fine, but I need a good life. I want freedom from pain. I want a reasonable degree of wealth and happiness. So how do I achieve that? This is the crux of the matter. Simple part. If you, rather than being a passive subject of destiny, say proactively that you will now create your life path, which will be holistic, whose end goal will be your spiritual growth, then you tell your own mind and the universe that it represents that now I am creating my destiny. I want all of these things, not because I want to be stinkingly rich, but because they are needed. The goal is now clear to me, and I am creating this journey now. If that will happen, random events will stop happening to your life, and what you genuinely need to grow, whether it be wealth or other things, will flow into your life. I am going to stop here because I don't want to make this video long, because I will have to make 2 more videos. I will tell you what the Buddha did. I will tell you what Nanak said. And I will tell you a lot more from the Upanishads. But I can assure you that once you understand life's goal and build your path, you will see the universe or your mind removing obstacles in your way rapidly and giving you whatever you need to create your spiritual fulfillment. Thank you.